Good day. My name is Ugochukwu Ukwemu, and in this tutorial guide, I will show you how to deploy a pre-built website code into a Compute Engine virtual machine and serve the website from Google Cloud Platform. In this tutorial, I will clone the database of a pre-built website from GitHub into a virtual machine server and serve the website files over the internet. This tutorial builds on a previous tutorial, how to set up a Compute Engine virtual machine on GCP and install LAMP stack on the server. So let's get on with our live presentation. So the first thing I want to do is log back onto my Google Cloud Platform console, right? And the prerequisite to follow along with this is a previous tutorial which I've done. The link to which you're going to find below this video, or you can also find the link in the accompanying blog, right? So that's pretty much the prerequisite to this hands-on tutorial. So just go there, complete that video tutorial, and then you'll be up to speed. In that tutorial, we set up a Compute Engine virtual machine server, and we configured it with a LAMP stack, that's Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP, and with which that server is ready to serve pretty much any dynamic website built on PHP. So, and well, that's the server already set up and running. If you follow the first guide, you can see we've already set up the server. It's running and it has some pages on it already, right? So we're pretty much going to continue from it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to SSH into that machine by copying our command line code. We also have an op the option of SSHing into this machine from the cloud-based console terminal, but I prefer using my Google Cloud SDK shell. So I pretty much copied the command there to SSH into that machine, and I entered into it, right? So that's my terminal into the machine. So let's do an ls. Let me cd into the HTML directory of the Apache website. Right, and you can see these are the pages that we can see serving here, right? But of course, in practice, we don't want to be writing our code on the live server. What usually happens is usually a dev environment where developers can build their code. After building their code and it's ready, they can deploy their code from their dev machine into the live server. Right, into the server, so what some of us call production server or even dev development server. Another option is to push your code from your dev machine into a code repository like GitHub or GitLab, and then from there you can pull or clone your code into your production or development machine. Now that approach suits when there's a team of developers, and so there's a central code repository and everyone can contribute to that code repository. Right. And so pretty much, and there is also the other option. We could move our code base to like an object store, like Google Cloud Store, and then from there pull the code into our virtual machine, right? That's a pretty much a standard and even recommended approach to for the cloud store, Google Cloud Store, to serve as an ingestion point for all kinds of data into our virtual machine, right? So that's a standard approach that you've recommended in standard Google Cloud Platform guide. But the approach we'll be using here is our code. We have a code base already available on GitHub. We're going to go clone it and then install it on this machine. So let's go to GitHub. The code base we'll be using is going to find at github.com, engineering, then computer shop 2. All right, so It's a publicly available code. This is my GitHub repository or GitHub account. So I put up that code there for and made it available really. So in case you want to, play around with this lab and follow along with it, but you might have your own code ready and yeah, you're free. Use your own code, right? So, but then what's in this code? So it's a standard practice when you visit a code base to see if the readme note, right? So this code base is a demo website for a computer shop. So this is a demo website for a retail shop, in this case, a computer shop. It was built using HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and some PHP code to process the contact form. This code can be downloaded and used by anyone cutting their teeth in website design. Feel free to modify it and make it your own. A functioning version of this demo website can be seen on that URL provided. Cheers, right? So for us, we just, so this code base is ready, full ready. We just want to pull it into our virtual machine or clone it into a virtual machine and save it from the virtual machine we've set up for this tutorial, right? Or at least we set up in a previous tutorial. So we are here. These are the files in the tutorial right now. Okay, so I want to pull the so the way to clone it is I think I've copy I've copy okay yeah I've cop I've copied that git clone the which gives me the address, right? So I've copied this. So I go into my terminal and I do a sudo git clone and I paste the URL I copied from there, right? And that's yeah. So if we do an ls, we see that we have that file, computer shop 2. Here, right? So let's cd into that. There's a directory. Computer shop 2 and ls, right? We see we have all the pages that make up that website. So, and of course, it's not in the root directory of our Apache server. So I'm going to move everything from here to the root directory. So this is our index.php is our index file here. So the command to move everything is move all to the lower directory. Okay, permission denied because I need to sudo that command. All right, so that's done. So you can see it's moved everything. So let me move to the directory and I do an ls, right? You see we have the web pages of our demo website. So and the homepage of our demo website is index.php. Recall this index.html is the homepage for the Apache server. So let's go to our server. Let's copy our external IP address, go to a new place, paste it, and that was index.php, right? And so that's pretty much the a fully functional website, right? And a few scripts, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and you have it there. At the bottom of the website, you have a contact form. You can play around with it. Let's see. Let's even investigate the code base of that script of that index page. So we have a CHCE index dot PHP, right? So this is it, pre-built, pre-tested. Okay, let me do a sudo. So that's it. So this is pretty much you could clone it in your dev environment and investigate and look around it, right? So this is not a tutorial on HTML, CSS, JavaScript. So it's pretty much demonstrating. So let me scroll up and see what's really happening here. Just a very brief description. So these are the pages, right? This is different from the bare bones script you ran to display to-dos list, right? So yeah. So that's it, right? You can look at it, borrow it. It has everything. Let me see if I can look at somewhere that might interest us. Okay, so this is the contact form section, right? So we have this, and it takes input from a user and then processes it, right? So that's that. So we've pulled, pretty much done what we need to do. We've pulled data. We've deployed a pre-built website code into our computer engine virtual machine, and we've served it, right? So this is everything. I'm not going to test the contact page right now because it's not been fully configured for the server. It still needs some other configuration to process the contact form and send a mail, send this message as a mail to maybe the owners of the website, right? So, but we've done what we need to do. So this is the basis. This is how full stack websites are built, right? They build in a dev environment. You set up your server, and then you pull your code into your server, put all the necessary, install all the necessary dependencies, and then serve your website. Of course, there are several other configurations that you need to do, set up security, but this is the basics, right? So with this coupled with the previous tutorials on how to set up the virtual machine, if you're a full stack developer, you now have all the information you need to start deploying to the cloud, right? I'm playing with the cloud. It's pretty powerful. It's pretty useful. I know the powers. If you've used legacy technologies and you compare that with the experience of cloud, it's on another level, right? So that's done. We've achieved the purpose of this website tutorial. There will still be more tutorials. We're going to build on this, right? So feel free, if you find this video useful, do like and subscribe to my channel. And if you have questions, drop them in the comment section below, right? And there's an accompanying blog to this video, right? All the commands I use are in that blog. So feel free, go to the blog, copy the commands, paste, and practice at your own free time, right? But of course, you're not going to be able to access this live server right now because I'm going to shut down that virtual machine. But if you have your own Google Cloud Platform account, which I would encourage you to have if you want to get into cloud, you can pretty much play with this laboratory. And once you're done, you could shut down the virtual machine to save on costs, right? So the hands-on approach I use here is to so that you can get a practical experience of cloud technologies. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed it. All the best. Good luck.